Did you? Yeah, here it's got a day. San Antonio. How's JJ?
She's doing good. So we're gonna go see that.
Oh, yeah? Yeah?
Much better. Good.
All right, deal.
Hi, Miguel. Both of you, Miguel.
Is this being recorded?
Major being recorded. Go around and around, huh?
Yeah.
He's dressed and I may not need it.
Built upon love, which virtue is best portrayed in 1 Corinthians. Love is patient, kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist upon its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. So faith, hope, and love abide these three. Without marriage, I've been married a long time now, so I've learned a whole lot of things about my life. Don't call this stuff. The reason that we're here is because God has ordained that we should do this. He said that we would choose to join together and unite and build a home. It's something else, though, as far as the social authority is concerned. It says to all those friends, all those people and acquaintances that we know, and the whole world, I'm choosing this person. Now, as a result of that, there are some responsibilities and also the relational side. This point forward, no one has a right to intervene between the two of you. No one. Let me illustrate this a little bit. When family members come along and say, well, you know, I wouldn't take that off of him, or I wouldn't let her do that, you tell them at that time, it's time to mind your business. Because this relationship should not be person that has any right to this relationship, and it's God. There's something else, responsibility that goes with this. From this point forward, you're going to be responsible for each other. That means that the mayor is sick, Michael, you're supposed to hold her head. That means that he is sick, then you have to attend to him. That means that you won't go out with the boys, and you've already told the neighbor, I'm going to do nothing so with you, then you're going to have to tell the boys, no. And they do the same thing as far as the girls are concerned. They're going to want you to go do this or that with them. You've already told him you're going to clean the house. And you've already told him that what you're going to do. And at that point, you ought to say to the girls, no, I've got something I've already promised my husband I'm going to do. See how this works? Be beautiful if it works that way. Somehow or other, I just know it's not always going to be that way. But anyway, so there's the reason and there's the responsibility and then there's the relationship. As I mentioned a moment ago, no one has any right to interfere with you to appear. Let your opinions be shared with one another and let nobody else's opinions come to you. You always do that. If you're in agreement with this, then we will change the vows at this time. Michael, will you take the maid to be your wife and will you commit yourself to her happiness, to her self-fulfillment as a person, and to her usefulness in God's kingdom, and will you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve her in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, be true and loyal to her so long as you both are with her? Maid, will you take Michael to be your husband? Will you commit yourself to his happiness and to his self-fulfillment as a person, and to his usefulness in God's kingdom? And will you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve him in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him so long as you both shall live? At this time, we will exchange the ring. The wedding ring is a symbol of your marriage in at least two ways. Purity symbolizes, the gold symbolizes the purity of your love for each other, and the honeymoon circle symbolizes the unending vows which you're taking, which may be broken only in the sight of God, only in the foundation. Michael, will you use the ring and repeat after your blessings? You may, this ring I pledge my life, this way I pledge my life, and love to you, and love to you. In the name of the Father, and the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Today you will hear the ring, please repeat after me. Michael.
Michael.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I pledge my love.
I pledge my life.
And life to you.
And life to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
Holy Spirit. Treat me not to leave you, or return to follow you. From where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God shall be my God. We can pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you and now pronounce you your Father.
not a lot of light.
There's light.
Yeah, it needs more light, but it's at least it's taking it.
You get more lights on it.
Oh,
then you can zoom right in on the piece and just kind of get it down. Now come down the piece. And to the right. When you come okay, down there. Right? Up the step. Can you zoom any more on that?
Mm-hmm. Right there. There's a lot. It's a little wobbly. Oh. It's a little bright in here, huh?
Do it.
What are you doing, dude?
Shut up. Yeah, go, go.
Is that the fourth that I take?
Shut up. It's like, it's just a moonshot.
The moon, dude.
It's the moonshine, dude. Check it out.
Like, just walked off like maybe didn't see him, you know? Anna's got all this pumpkin shit hanging off her face.
Hey!
So recording. Get in our pumpkins car for Halloween.
Halloween?
Halloween.
Be sure to get the other ones on there.
I'm gonna go
the
get
them. The ghoulish holiday!
Damn it.
What are you doing, doofus head?
Let me step back a little bit, Jay. Let me see that.
Oh, no, I'm right in the middle of this.
Oh,
car.
Okay.
Right on an eyebrow. This is its beginning.
Very good.
The Dracula pumpkin.
There's the pumpkin faces. He's already carved in my Halloween. One in the window. Cool, huh? See how neat? Look at the eyes carved out. This is the other one. Cool, this guy's ribbly looking. These are pumpkins, but the candles are on the inside so you can just sit. This is the other one. This is our evil witch. Aren't they cool? Let's carve them. They're so neat. He's got two more to go. The one in my window is a baby. Can't hardly see it. getting it further?
Oh, yeah.
Pumpkin man, pumpkin man. Jason carves the pumpkin man.
Cool. Keep singing, Rob. We have to have.
Oh, have to have sound.
Have to have sound.
All right. Cool. He carves out the eyes and cuts a little nose. This old pumpkin is going in the front yard. And after Halloween, you will be put to death. Death. All right, do the hot beat. Hello, this is America. Only in America can you carve such pumpkins and display them in front of your house. In India, this is not acceptable. In Morocco, yes. India, no.
Yeah,
okay, now he's got eyes.
Oh, he's ready to go, man.
He's ready to have his candle lit, huh?
Yep.
All right.
Come on, baby, light my fire.
Cool.
Come on, baby, bite my wife.
Robert.
How about, come on, baby,
bite my wife.
Can you dig it?
Groovy.
Is it groovy? Yeah, it's groovy. Even though you do not know what we are talking about, we do understand each other.
Indeed. It's code.
It's code words.
It's coded message. And in the Halloween spirit,
no, Robert.
Pumpkin Man must be
drunk, huh?
Initiated.
Damon.
Well, you gotta have some kind of buzz. Damon. Sit on the front yard all night and all day. Hey. This is the life of the jack-o'-lantern. First to be...
Okay, he finished the fourth one. There it is. Finished work. Cool, huh? Look how they show up.
Yeah, no kidding.
Mr. Happy. With his one tooth. And Mr.
Confused, I think.
And Mr. Evil.
Cool.
I think they're great. You're recording.
You aren't recording.
You are. I was.
No, you weren't. Oh, were you?
God, they look so fun. Get all four of them in there.
They look good, eh?
Mm-hmm. They look great.
Good deal.
Neat, huh? The morning after. Not yet cut. We're gonna work on him, huh, Damon? Oh, now my baby girl. My big baby girl. Hi, big girl. How's you doing this morning, huh? How you doing? Where's your brick? Where's your brick, Anna? Where's your brick? Where's your brick? Pick it up. Anna, get your brick. Get it, sweetheart. Bring it to Mom. Bring Mom your brick. Good.
Erica!
Let me. What? What? Let me show you. Let's get your little arrow, your little feather. You should look darling. Show me your boots. Erica, show me your boots. Erica, show Mom all your boots, honey. Let me see your boots. Yeah, show me your boots. Show me your boots.
Hey, look, you know. Look.
So each team has been limited to one first down.
with 3.5 minutes to play in the scoreless first quarter.